You can stay in here for the rest of your life.
Do you know what you did? You fed me a lot of pretenses. You dragged me down here at this awful hour. You can't be nice to people like you. The only thing you understand is threats.
Hold on, Jerome. You know something? You're right.
Cheryl!
You can't be nice to some people. You want a threat? All right, I'll give you a threat. Either you drop these charges right now, or I will go to every newspaper in Milwaukee and tell them how Carlisle's had a poor little working girl thrown in the clink on drummed-up charges. Not only that, but I will tell them the man responsible is Carlisle's bald manager.
I would just like to say that I'm going to drop the charges.
Oh.
Because I don't want to see you around.
Yeah.
And keep away from Carlisle's dress shop. Do you hear me? And another thing, I have a lot of good friends, wealthy friends, and tough friends. And do you know something? They love me!
Learn fast. You're gonna be all right. I'm gonna give you another tip.
Oh, good. We love your tips.
Love those tips.
Enough.
You got to know how to handle yourself when you're out there under the big bull. Right, don't let them dance you into three places.
Where's that?
Darkness, up against walls, and the men's room.
Men's room?
Through that arch there.
Oh. Thank you, Charmaine. Thank you so much.
Don't ever thank me.
Don't ever thank me.
I don't like to be obligated.
Doesn't like it.
I run alone.
Runs alone.
Was born alone.
No.
I'm going to stay that way.
Well, I can certainly understand that. Have a nice night.
Don't tell me what to do.
Don't tell what to do.
How many times you got to be told don't tell her what to do? Don't say anything.
Bye, Laverne.
Could you point me to the fire exit, please?
You're not going anywhere, Feeny.
Yeah, show all the rotten things on her list.
Right. Helping Laverne steal 56 bucks from the phone company.
That's it?
That's it.
You mean I'm sentenced to rot in you-know-where for eternity just for playing an itty-bitty part in one of her countless sins?
Oh, look on the bright side, Cheryl. We're still roommates.
Roommates, shoemates. I demand to speak to the vile and loathsome creature that runs this wicked inferno.
Anna!
Thing that makes sense.
Do be careful who you choose to castigate. We can have you fricasseed.
And adieu, as they say, those two are the devil's favorites.
Pull in them chins, suck in them guts, and stick out them chests. I'm waiting.
So am I.
And you, pull back them shoulders.
Why, can't you see it's a habit? I mean, well, I was an early bloomer, and I always had to carry my books like this because the boys would always tease me. I mean, I guess you're used to that too, huh?
Stick it in your ear. I am your new drill sergeant. Sergeant Plout! I have been informed that both of you are strong, agile, and not good at anything in particular. I think I can change that.
Oh, I think you can, too.
I have been given permission to conduct an experimental program.
If you do that to me, too, my neck's killing me this way.
I'm going to prove to the Army that a woman can do anything a man can do.
Are we going to have to get them short little haircuts that'll make me look like Eddie Haskell?
If necessary to prove my point.
I'm going
to
look terrible.
When I prove with you two, you will be combat ready.
Think she's gone.
Disappeared. That?
She's
wrong.
What? I bet all the food. I mean, any person to blow in here and tumble.
I can't apologize enough for us having called you a fraud.
Yes, I did. Voila, monsieur. Looking for table scraps?
That's an old Lithuanian custom, saying grace under the table during dinner.
How sweet.
Yeah, could we have the check, please? We're all done here.
Yes, I know.
What are you doing under there?
No.
Get off under there.
No.
Be a man.
No.
Don't rip it to shreds.
Stop it. You want Squiggy to beat her up here?
Yeah.
Oh, come here, Squiggy. Come here. Come on.
No.
Voila,
monsieur. The check.
Oh, we're paying you under the table tonight, Francois.
I'm sorry to disturb you with your prayers. The check.
What, there's a French coin? 49.50. All right, who ordered the extra Pepsi?
I did.
Okay, Frenchie, here's $50. Keep the change.
Oh, monsieur. 50 cents. Goody. Now Tiny Claude can have his operation.